Well, we're back again with another vintage car. I scored when I found that box of cars, man. Anyway, I don't know exactly what year this is, but it's very 90s with the paint scheme. And as I'm sure you can tell, this is an RC10 GT. Let's get rid of the groovy body and look underneath. It has an OS CV12 like everything did back in the late, well, I should say in the early 90s, mid 90s. The red control arms or A arms, whatever you want to call them, that is paint. That's the way it was when I bought it. I bought this car used. 2001, I think I bought it. The only reason I bought it is because I wanted the controller. It's an old Airtronic Caliber 3P. Wanted the controller at the time, but mind you, this was 20 years ago. Never really had much luck with the truck. I got it to run a few times, but it never ran well. And when it did run, it was fast as shit, for what it was, but wasn't real impressive. This is the biggest bummer. And a much dumber, younger, less wise me did that. This was done with a bench grinder. And I did that because one-way bearings kept slipping. So I bought one of those HG purple things you chuck into a drill and try to start it. Well, the cordless drill I had at the time just went tuk 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 tuk. It was so slow, it didn't have enough speed to spin the motor over fast enough to get it to fire off. Mostly because there's no compression in that motor. Because the previous owner just beat the dog piss out of it. I mean, it was like watching Kevin Talbot's video, or Kevin Talbot's buddy. I can't think of his name off the top of my head, but he's got one speed and he breaks everything he touches. And that's the way the guy was that I got this thing from. I mean, it was just full speed or off. And he just destroyed everything. And pretty much everything that he owned. But anyway, the chances of me finding another chassis are very, very slim. But I don't know if you can tell. Look how deep those gouges are that I put in that. But goes to show how thick that chassis is. That's incredible. And I made it so I'll never be able to get that screw out. Way to go, Chad, you dumbass. Oh well. Oh, in case you didn't know, that's my name. My name's Chad. But this is down the row, down the list of things to put back together. I would like to strip all the paint off the A arms. I have my doubts that they'll ever come back to being white. I have a feeling they'll be pink, because I'm guessing probably the paint probably did dye the plastics a little bit, because you can see where the paint has rubbed off, it's still pink. This is the front bumper for it. I found that in another car yesterday. But I would like to get rid of the CV12. And the first thought was, well, I'll just put a brushless conversion on it and just go have fun with it. Something like just a cheap Ghoul RC, something, 3300 KV be plenty. But I think I will do another nitro motor, even though I hate nitro now. I mean, I was a huge nitro guy, 2001 through 2008, six. I was all into nitro. And then I discovered large scale gas cars, and that's when I got my FG, and never ever look back at nitro. It's like $20 a gallon for fuel, and you're constantly tuning these things, and you dick with the carburetor more than you do actually driving the thing, and it's like, it just isn't worth it. And I was all about big gasoline right up until, the brushless thing really took over in about 2008, 2009 is when all the brushless stuff started getting really popular. But it was still expensive. I mean, you were looking at buying like Novax and Hackers and all that kind of stuff, so never really had the money for that kind of stuff, so I just stuck with my gas burners. But
Anyway, that's beside the point. So, the favorite part for me of this car is the body. I didn't paint it. I do believe the guy that I bought it from a racer, and he painted it. It's got some little goofy touches on it, like this zip tie here. Well, what's that for? Well, some of you know, I'm sure. Some of you probably don't know. That zip tie comes through a hole in the roof. Like, yo. And when you come in to make a pit stop, you grab that zip tie, and it opens the lid on the fuel tank. Bloop. And then you fill her up with fuel. Just, little tricks like that. So, like I said, I bought the thing used. It was already used from a guy that he bought it used. So, but anyway, I don't see too many of these on YouTube. And the RC10 GTs, I or excuse me, the yeah, the RC10 GTs that I do see are usually the other chassis design, the later style, not the old bathtub. And I don't know if you caught that or not, but it's not the same thing as a gold chassis. And it's not the same thing as the black RC10T. Because as you can see, it's actually removed there for the pipe. It doesn't flare out like it does over here. But, well, here's another vintage RC. And please, I know that you guys are looking at this going, man, he's releasing all these videos of all these old cars and stuff. It's just because they've been sitting in a box for 20 years and I haven't been able to find it. So now that I found them, I'm all excited. So I'm releasing all these old videos and stuff. And the first one of my vintage car releases I did was this, which is the JRX2. Which, now that they made the mini version of it, I thought about buying a new JRX2 Mini and comparing it to the full size, but it's a mini car that I'm not going to play with. It's like that Rolarlo thing or whatever it was. I put that on the channel hoping it was going to blow my channel up because it was a new car. It got like 50 views. I sent the car back to Amazon. I mean, I wasn't happy with it anyway. It was slow as shit. But, well, that's enough. I'm rambling. But I got my pint of black. And this was the body I was talking about in the last video. That was for the hell was this for? Oh, it was for the Gold Pan RC10. But it's actually not. This is a Hot Bodies Taurus SHO that somebody has painted in hammered paint. I believe that's what that is. Or they just didn't have any luck painting gold paint. But this was sitting in a shed in a different box. This was sitting in a shed for about 8, 10 years. And the squirrels got into the shed and just pooped all over everything. So the weird grossness that you see through the windows there, that's the poo. And this body reeks, man. It just smells like squirrel shit. But this body is actually huge. I mean, I was really surprised at how big. I'll get into that in another video. But anyway, well, have fun, guys. And if there's anything you want to see, let me know. I probably have it. All right, I'll talk to you in the next one.